Let's go meet strange stars in and beyond our galaxy. Some are very odd and mysterious to see. Let's go meet strange stars. There are many different kinds. They will blow your mind. Let's go and meet strange stars. We'll travel very far out through our universe. I wonder who we'll meet first. Will we meet a fake diamond star sparkling more than the other stars are? Will we meet a heavy metal star surrounded by lead-filled clouds? How bizarre. Will we meet a polka dot star with interacting chromospheres where giant stellar spots are? Will we meet the oldest known sub-giant? I really love science. I'm a very unique star because I do extra sparkling. I'm a hot sub-dwarf star, LS IV 14116. Above my blue surface are clouds of zirconium that make me glittery. Between the constellations Capricornus and Aquarius, you can find me.
I look like a giant peanut. I'm HR 5171, a contact binary star, a yellow hypergiant with my cool giant companion. We're also an eclipsing binary star. My companion orbits me regularly. In the constellation Centaurus is where you'll find me.
Our name is RS Canum Venaticorum, a close eclipsing binary star in the Canis Venatici constellation. We have interactive chromospheres which create large, cool stars. Spots that make our brightness vary and look like giant polka dots.
I'm Methuselah, one of the oldest stars. Getting old is a curse. I'm not quite sure of my age. Am I older than the universe? That doesn't make sense, but I was around when the universe was forming. Born in a primeval dwarf galaxy, find me in Libra, still performing.
Who else is out there?
AR Scorpii in the Scorpius constellation, an exotic binary star. A red dwarf star with a rare white dwarf pulsar. Every 2 minutes, I'm hit with beams of radiation from my little spinning companion, causing our entire system to brighten and fade dramatically again and again.
In the Cygnus constellation, they call me Janus, the star with two faces. My makeup is fairly typical. I have hydrogen and helium gases. What's strange is that my helium gas is on one side and my hydrogen is on the other. An exotic transitioning white dwarf with two halves separate from one another.
From the Cetus constellation, I'm UV Ceti, and I make people nervous. I'm a flare star, and I have sudden and often eruptions from my surface. They flare up fast and calm more slowly, and then the process repeats. The first flare star discovered, they classify flare stars, UV Ceti stars, after me.
I am a heavy metal subdwarf star, AG-2359-2844, a dwarf star with lead-filled clouds for the constellation Scorpii.
I have 10,000 tabs more yttrium and zirconium than you, sir.
Stars like me are a link between red rim giants and faint blue subdwarf stars. Rock on!
Who else is out there?
Let's go meet strange stars in and beyond our galaxy. Some are very odd and mysterious to see. Let's go meet strange stars. There are many different kinds. They will blow your mind. Let's go and meet strange stars. We'll travel very far out through our universe. I wonder who we'll meet first. Will we meet a septuple star, a star system made up of seven stars? Will we meet a black widow binary star destroying its mate? How bizarre! Will we meet a triple protostar? Triplet newborn stars, they are. Will we meet a strange binary star, a black hole, and supergiant? I really love science!
In the constellation Scorpius, Scorpii, a rare septuple star system, seven stars. You can count us. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A pair of stars orbited by another star, and all three stars orbited by another, and another pair of stars orbiting another star. And this trio orbits all the others.
A black widow binary star, ZTF J1406+1222 A pulsar destroying my mate, just like black widow spiders do. My heat evaporates my tightly locked companion as we circle each other every 62 minutes. And a third star orbits us every 10,000 years, observing from its faraway orbit.
The odd couple, M51, ULS1, and ultraluminous strange binary star.
A blue supergiant and stellar remnant, probably a black hole is what we are.
We may have the first extragalactic planet detected here in the Whirlpool Galaxy.
The constellation Canis Venaticorum is where you'll find our family.
In the Perseus constellation, L1448 IRS3B. Not a single star or two. No, we are three.
Triplets, three newborn stars discovered all together in a rare configuration.
Giving astronomers a glimpse of a star-forming disk with a triple protostar system.
Who else is out there?
I think there is one more set of stars to meet. Take it away, stars.
We're Orion's Belt. I'm Mintaka.
I'm Alnilam.
I'm Alnitak.
Three of the most popular, easily identifiable stars seen from your planet.
We make up Orion's Belt, one of the most distinct constellations in your sky.
So many of you asked to meet us. We dropped by to say hi.
Who else is out there?
We've only scratched the surface. There are billions of stars, you see. But now we've met a few and understand their diversity. Let's keep on exploring our wondrous universe. Keep discovering new stars. Which star will you meet first?
Rock on!
Still haven't seen your favorite star yet? Don't worry. There are billions of stars to meet, and we need your help. Can you believe we've met 87 stars and star systems so far? And in Meet the Stars Part 8, we'll meet our 100th star! We're looking for 13 unique, amazing, and extreme stars! Can you find an incredibly amazing star for us to meet? Send your star votes to info@naworldmusic.net. We'll pick 12 fascinating stars and one extra special star for our 100th star in Meet the Stars Part 8, arriving in 2025. Stay tuned for more fun videos. Thanks for watching. Bye!